are off in the Wood Memorial, and Tex goes out to the early lead. Jovia goes right with him, and having to take back off of them is Tacitus, who will be third early on. And then it's Overdeliver in fourth. Not that Brady is next. Overdeliver had traffic trouble on that turn. And then on the inside is Hoffa's Union. A break of another length and a half. And then comes Outshine on the outside of Haikal. Final Jeopardy is next. And then comes Math Wizard and Grump's Little Tots. 23.62 was the opening quarter mile. Onto the back stretch with Not That Brady and Jovia together on the lead. They've opened up a five-length advantage on Tax. Tacitus is running along in fourth. He's eight lengths off the lead. Then it's Hoffa's Union, Overdeliver. Outshine is a good 12 lengths behind as they scatter up the backstretch at a good pace up top. Then comes Haikal, followed by Math Wizard to the outside. And then it's Grump's Little Tots. And now the trailer is Final Jeopardy after a 46.91 half mile. So the battle continues. Not That Brady on the outside and Jovia at the rail. These two 7 lengths in front of the field as they make their way around the turn. Tax is now asked to run in third, 6 lengths off the lead. Tacitus still has 8 lengths to make up. Then it's Hoffa's Union. They're making their way to the top of the stretch. Not That Brady has put away Jovia, but here come Tex and Tacitus with their runs. 3/4 in 111.46, and they're into the stretch. And here comes Tex and Tacitus. And the two of them are right together as they come to the eight pole. Longshot Math Wizard has run a big one. He's third to the outside. Tacitus on the outside. Tex along the rail. Tacitus and Tex locked in battle at the 16th pole. It's Tacitus in front. Tex second on the inside as they come down to the line. Haikal takes third late. It is Tacitus in the Wood Memorial. Tex was second. Haikal was third. Math Wizard was fourth in 151.23.
Tacitus, your winner of the Wood Memorial, already had enough points to qualify for the Kentucky Derby. Just wanted to make sure he was going in with extra momentum.
Yeah, good redemption day for trainer Bill Mott, who was disappointing last week with Hidden Scroll in the Florida Derby. But this was a great effort by this colt in only his fourth start of the year. He was some 7 or 8 lengths off the lead, but in a perfect position in fourth. His jockey, Jose Ortiz, now has some decisions to make because he's got a plethora of riches. Very professional effort by Tacitus. Final Jeopardy got eliminated at the start, Randy.
Yeah, this horse, Tacitus, I mean, he didn't corner all that well going into the first turn. Something was going on there, and he had to veer out a little bit over some heels. But once he got settled down behind horses, the pace definitely helped his chances, because Not That Brady and Jovia went screaming out there early. For how slow the track is today at Aqueduct, it was an exceptionally fast pace, the same sort of pace setup that Tacitus had the last time he ran in the Tampa Bay Derby. But I agree, a very workmanlike performance. Now let's check out Final Jeopardy. Here at the start, Jerry alluded to trouble leaving the starting gate from post position number 5 being eliminated, and hopefully we'll be able to get another look at that here shortly.
Yeah, Final Jeopardy, the number 5 horse in the race. Certainly a lot of people had high hopes for him, but Tacitus, it is the Bill Mott horse. It has been a bit of a rough go for Bill Mott and some of his sort. Hidden Scroll was a Bill Mott horse, underperformed. Country House underperformed a bit.
Country House is now going to run in the Arkansas Derby next week. And here's another look at the head-on. There might have been a little contact.
Yeah, I
could
notice from the side shot that Tacitus kind of drifted in, the gray horse, in toward Tax a little bit. Maybe some incidental contact. I don't know if there's a claim of foul, but there was a little movement. Tacitus wasn't completely clear when he came over.
So the first Wood Memorial win for Bill Mott. He got off the schneid there, 0-7 previously in the Wood Memorial, and now he'll go on to Kentucky. Post 5, Final Jeopardy.
Watch the 6th horse breaks, and he will get some pressure from the outside and forces him into Final Jeopardy. Boom! Even Tacitus got a little bit of it. As Randy alluded, he had a little problem going in the first turn, but Final Jeopardy completely eliminated there.
And right here, Tacitus also had not the smoothest run as they go into the first turn. He had to steady just a little bit right there as well. So the winner didn't have everything completely his own way, and now we're told that the inquiry light is up. So the stewards will be taking a look, maybe at the incident early, but probably the stretch run where they came together.
Could be both.
Yes,
as a jockey in that situation, you see a start like that, what are you trying to do?
Well, you're trying to force your horse up in there shoulder to shoulder so you don't be the ham in a sandwich, you don't get squeezed out the back. But sometimes you can't get in there deep enough into the hole to hold your position, and you just get squirted out the back.
So we'll see what happens when the stewards look at this. Tacitus, when you look ahead now to the Kentucky Derby, he has a beautiful pedigree for Churchill Downs. He's by Tappet, who is one of the more successful sires in America right now, maybe the most successful, and he's out of a mare named Close Hatches, who is a Grade One winner.
Won five Grade Ones.
So distance is going to be no problem whatsoever. So we're going to take one more look now at the start.
It'll be interesting to hear what Jose Ortiz says about this ride after he's done. Didn't think the horses given him 100% up to this point. Maybe that was different today. Here's the beginning. See anything there, guys?
Yeah, well, the white bridle, pink silks is Final Jeopardy. Now, the pressure comes from the outside. It appears to be the horse Jovia that set the pace. He's the one that caused the crowding. Number two, Tacitus, forced up in there because you have to as a jockey. You have to hold your position. Final Jeopardy wasn't quite up in there enough, so he got the worst of it.
And the deep stretch now, one more look at Tacitus and Tax, right? Tax on the inside, Tacitus on the outside. When you look at the head on.
And watch their feet.
Right. You can look at it's sort of the path they're taking by watching the harrow marks on the racetrack. And also keep in mind that stewards are loath in major races like this to make any disqualifications whatsoever. I look at that, Jerry, and I think, no, nothing's going to happen.
Probably not. This inquiry could definitely be against Jovia, who caused all the problems earlier.
So what we're hearing now is the inquiry does not involve the top four. So the inquiry is not about the top four, not the deep stretch run. So it was what happened earlier in the race. And so it appears that those horses in the top four will stay in the top four.
What do they think they are? Bumper cars? Come on. Straighten them up.
So it will be Tacitus. We knew he was going to the Derby. Now going in with perhaps a little bit more momentum for Bill Mott and jockey Jose Ortiz. They can say they've won the Wood Memorials for the first time.